My dad was a man's man. My dad was a fucking man's man. So when I turned 16, my brother and I a car. He got us this 1977 Dodge Aspen station wagon. Okay, this is what he thought we would be safe in. Big ass, old school station wagon. Wood, it was a limited edition too. Wood panel on the side, tinted windows. Side note, it also happened to be one of my cousin's wedding limos. That's where we're coming from. We got it secondhand. Who's old enough to remember when high beams were down here on the floor? Yeah, where they fucking should be. Unless you're missing a left foot. Then they're where they are. Had early power steering, like when you would just touch the wheel of your car, be like, aah! All off the road. I'm like, this is super dangerous. Why are you giving it? You just breathe on it. It's like, aah! AM radio, when you'd hit the gas, the accelerator noise would come through the speakers, like, just put FM on, goddammit. Just put FM on. So that was our car. And we picked up everyone in the neighborhood. We'd load that thing up, 8 or 9 kids, and we'd go out at night. And then when at the end of the night came, you had to be home 12 or 1 o'clock in the morning, we dropped you off. And if you didn't kick in on gas money, we blew the shit out of that loud-ass horn all through your neighborhood. We'd even make a lap back around, like, come on, you're waking up my parents! Waking up the whole neighborhood. Kick in some gas money next time, that asshole. We would hold it for like 3 minutes. That doesn't sound like a long time, but tonight when you're driving home, hold your horn for 3 straight minutes. It's a long fucking time. We did it so much, and this car's getting double duty on it, me and my brother, that the horn started to short. And just, you'd be out riding around, rolling up, bang, bang. Like, oh, it's starting to give out, man. We burnt this thing out. And my dad had no idea what we were doing. And one day, he's driving the car. I'm up front, my brother's in the back. We're at a stoplight, there's a car in front of us. And I'm like, I look back at my brother right away, we start dying. The guy in front of us is like, what the fuck's your problem, asshole? My dad's like, I don't know, it's an old car. I'm not sure, it's the horn. It's not me. I'm not, look, here's my hand. Here's my hand, man. The guy's like, fuck you. My dad's like, fuck you. I got my kids in the car. Don't talk like that. Dying laughing. Can't breathe. Cannot breathe. So my dad worked so hard. This poor dude, he worked doubles. We lived in Baltimore. He would drive to D.C. He worked at National Airport. He was a crew chief for Pan Am, nicknamed Lefty. And all the dude wanted to do when he came home was sleep. Like, he worked so hard to take care of us. And there was a February when he had got home at like 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning, finally got to sleep, and that car was parked right up on the house. And in the middle of the night, and we're like, what? It sounded like a tugboat coming through the house. We jump up out of bed like, oh, shit. Like, we know Dad's going to be. We're over there, and I just see this figure walk by our bedroom in tighty whities and work boots. That's it. And he goes outside. 2 degrees. Horns blaring the whole time. We're looking out the window like, oh, shit. Opens up the door. Pops the hood from the inside, walks around the front, pops the hood in his face. And then I see him pull a buck knife out of his underpants. Cuts the horn line, slams the hood down, comes back in, walks by our bedroom, says, game's over. We're like, oh, shit! Dad knew the whole time! That's a fucking man's man. If that was me, I'd be out there cutting all kinds. Like, I don't know why I still got his fan belts and shit all on the ground. I didn't even know the horn had a line. I had no idea. I got a butter knife. I don't know what's going on. But that was a fucking man's man.